Hello, you are welcome back to the Science Hub Mission Institute.
Michelle Bagoni.
Tiffany McKenna.
Today we'll be continuing with the gaseous exchange, but it will be in mammals.
Okay, so in mammals, the human beings are used to represent, and the structures involved are lungs, trachea, chest cavity, diaphragm, and nostrils. Okay, so the nose has two openings called the nostrils, which let air into the in through the air passages. Then we have the voice box, and it is located on top of the trachea, and it has muscle fibers and vocal cords containing the pitch of the voice. We then have the trachea. It is a tube made up of rings of cartilage, which ensure that it does not collapse during breathing. We then go on to the lungs. The lungs are formed in the chest cavity, and they are enclosed in a double membrane known as the pleural membrane. And now leave it to you to explain the mechanism of breathing.
Okay, in the mechanism of breathing, we have inspiration. This is when we breathe in air. Then we have expiration. This is when we take out air. So I'll go to the differences of inspiration and expiration. In inspiration, the thoracic cavity increases in volume while decreases in pressure, while in exhalation, the thoracic cavity decreases while it increases in pressure. Then in inspiration, the internal muscles contract while the internal muscles relax, while in the expiration, the internal muscles relax and the internal muscles contract. I'll now leave it on to my colleague Titu.
We're going to learn about factors affecting the rate of breathing. We have six factors that affect the rate of breathing. That is exercise, age, emotions, temperature, and altitude. I'll give an example. Adaptation of high altitude. As we know, some people living in high altitude adapt to low oxygen tension in a number of ways. People living in high altitude, these are people living in in hills and in high places. Fast adaptation, they have to increase the number of the red blood cells and the total hemoglobin to enable them to absorb the transport of sufficient oxygen. This is, as you all know, the more the red blood cells, the more efficient oxygen will be transported. So they need, because they have low oxygen is sufficient at the high altitude areas, so they need more red blood cells to increase the absorption of oxygen. And to my second point, they have a large thorax, enabling them to increase their vital capacity of the lungs. They have a large, their lungs increase in size, so as to make their breathing easier, not difficult, because of the low altitude. And to my third point, they have red blood cells account at a high hemoglobin encounter and more extensive vascularized of the tissues. So these are my third point. It's explaining from what I said from my first point. They need more red blood cells for them to have sufficient oxygen during those places.
We have come to the end of our discussion today on Science Hub. I have been Tiffany McKenna,
Michelle Gagoni,
Michelle Titu.
Keep it Elimo TV, where we watch and learn.